How you guys doing? Welcome to another episode of Mayhem Championship Wrestling. Tonight's episode is Tuesday Night Takedown. Now I'm cutting you off to Dave, Graham, and Isaac, but Graham's in the back. And Isaac, how you doing?
Hola de Holmes.
And the devious one, your favorite Canadian, Dave Rose.
That's right, the one and only devious Dave Rose is here on Tuesday Takedown, exclusively on MCW.
So we have a very good lineup of matches tonight. We're going to be having a championship defending already. Can you give me some background behind this match, Dave?
Now, this is unbelievable. The fact is that it's been recognized after the incredible match on Sunday night at Mayhem Championship Wrestling. MayhemMania had Graham Hall lose against Mark Mayhem and Devious Dave Rose. But that being said, Graham Hall has been determined to be the number one contender for the new MCW Global Championship title. And tonight, we finally get to see a match that's been in the making for quite some time. Dead on Dave versus Graham Hall for the MCW Global Championship title. And I have to tell you, Mark Mayhem, I am looking forward to tonight's match.
Who do you think might win this?
Ooh. Well, that's a good question. I want to relay that to the one and only Isaac Emerald, who is here exclusively at the announcement table.
You know, both of these guys, they have what it takes to be champion, but just for the fact that the unpinnable has been pinned by one of these opponents, I'm going to have to go with the dead one, Dead on Dave.
Now, my thoughts on the matter are that although I do respect Dead on Dave and did watch that match, and he did prove himself to be quite astute, the fact of the matter is that I believe Graham Hall may just win this one tonight because the spirit and heart that he showed against me and Mark Mayhem in the main event match of Mayhem Mania proved to me that he is truly one of the greatest, not just here in MCW, but in the entire wrestling industry.
I must say, that belt looks great on Dave, but I feel it would look better on Graham. So I'm putting my money on Graham in this match.
Because I'm Mexican? Is that why you guys want to disagree with me, huh?
It's all about statistics and analysis. And when you get up to our level, Emerald, you might understand a few things.
Oh, so I have to be on a certain level. Am I supposed to go on some type of elevator or something?
Well, last time I checked, both of your knees are a little faulty, so you may want to watch your words before you have to watch your knees. How about that?
Let's just get to the damn match.
Graham's bringing back the power walk. It means business.
Maybe he's trying to lose a little weight.
You know, there are rumors online that Graham Hall is starting Jenny Craig, and looks like it's getting put into work tonight.
Hey, whatever works, as they say.
Wax on, wax off.
Another pair of famous words coming from a famous man, Isaac Emerald himself.
I love this new belt.
This is, in fact, the MCW Global Championship title. Truly a prestigious title here in MCW.
Dave handing the belt to the ref. And that's what's all on the line for tonight.
Shout out to our ring announcer, only here at MCW, Julio Ricardo.
Now, if I was him, I'd be watching out, because you never know when they're going to be using that table for a little bit of action.
Me and the ring announcer Julio Ricardo go way back to my sister's bar mitzvah. Nice dude.
Mazel tov.
What?
Isn't that what they say at those bar mitzvahs?
I'm Mexican. And we're off to the match.
Now, I gotta say, I think Dead on Dave might be a little full of himself. I think maybe the hubris is getting to his brain, because even though he won the match on Sunday night at Mayhem Mania, I don't think he knows how hungry Graham is after that big loss at the main event on Sunday.
Graham's showing no remorse, though. He's putting all of his effort into this match because he knows he can win another championship, no matter who it is.
Well, then again, I wouldn't ever count out Dead on Dave. Fact of the matter is that his copious splashes have put out many competitors.
But as you can see by that diving hurricane rana, he's not as athletic as Graham Hall.
Well, that's a surprise considering Graham's size, but that is one of the things that I will yield to him, that he is quite athletic considering his large stature.
But don't get me wrong, we could see stuff coming out of the bag from the Dead on Dave.
I know his fans are quite crazy about him. They call themselves the Deadites, and they're more than willing to run out of the stands and try to attack any wrestlers that might hurt their biggest idol.
Strike by strike, it seems Graham Hall's getting very allergic in this match as he has been continuing to go on the top rope, and it seems like he's been doing nothing but getting better since Sunday night's loss.
Graham is looking very serious in this match tonight.
Looking very determined to win that new championship. You know him, he wants everything new. Just ask his wife. Hopefully there's no shenanigans tonight, as we have got new refs.
That's right. After a thorough investigation by Mark Mayhem himself, it's been determined that a whole entire corrupt section of the referees was affecting their decisions, and he fired every single one of them. Every new referee that you see here has been totally pre-screened, and it's been ensured that they are not on the take.
Speaking of taking, it seems like Graham Hall is looking to take that new championship. But Dead on Dave, you gotta see, the fact of the matter is that he's actually pulling through, showing no remorse for this title match.
I'm starting to rethink my decision that Graham might win this match.
And I'm starting to rethink my decision that Dead on Dave's gonna win this match.
You guys are flip-flopping more than Michael Jackson at Pancake House.
Oh, I'm just amazed at these two individuals, these two huge heavyweights just going at it here in the ring at MCW. Just unbelievable.
You see Graham Hall holding his knee after Dead on Dave just slamming it to the mat.
I'm just surprised that both of you aren't able to understand the concept that we're seeing here today. Because the fact is, these two individuals seem to be defying physics itself, considering they're flying through the air and doing these great aerobatic acts.
Well, Graham has a little Samoan in him, so he gets those.
You have the proof?
Somewhere.
Okay. Until we see proof, we're not going to believe one word from you, champ.
These huge hits,
should I say, jumps
are taking tonight.
I've never seen Graham fly so much.
These competitors seem to have it out here tonight at this match.
It seems like Graham Hall's had like a new ambassador teaching him all these new moves. He might have studied more luchadoric type moves before this match.
Now, one thing I will mention is the fact that, again, these two competitors are trained U.S. soldiers. And the fact that neither of them is killing the other is just blowing my mind. That shows a lot of restraint on both sides.
Graham really wants his boat.
Now, normally some of those hits would just incapacitate a regular sized wrestler, but Dead On Dave has shown himself to be truly one of the greatest heavyweights here at MCW, and they're not doing as much damage as Graham Hall may want.
Oh my gosh! A new champion!
Oh my goodness!
That came out of the blue. Unbelievable.
Are you kidding me?
That has to be the shortest title reign in MCW history.
It's been 24 hours and Dead On Dave has lost the belt.
48
Ladies and gentlemen, we have a new champion here at MCW. Graham Hall is now the MCW Global Heavyweight Champion.
You see, there's the agility that I've been speaking to you about earlier on this match. Hopefully, we got Graham Hall, the new Global Heavyweight Champion, to our commentary table, asking his thoughts about his match. Man, if I was Dead On Dave, I would just be disappointed as hell. But hopefully, this isn't the last we've heard from Dead On Dave.
This once again proves that Graham Hall is truly one of the great heavyweights here at MCW.
Making Graham Hall the first one to win both the MCW Hardcore Championship and the MCW Global Championship.
Now that's quite the record there here at MCW. Unbelievable results.
And we're all to our next match.
Unbelievable.
I think Graham's going to come down to the ramp and just give us a few words.
Graham, you there?
Graham, someone get this guy a mic.
I'm going to go get the microphone down to Graham, and we'll see what his thoughts were on this match. All right, Graham Hall, the new MCW Global Champion. How are you feeling after that amazing win tonight?
Well, as y'all know, I wanted the Hardcore Championship, but circumstances as they were, I'm glad that the refs got found out and I got this second shot here. I'm sorry it had to be Dead On Dave. I really like the guy, but, you know, I gotta have gold around my belt. I gotta have gold around my waist. I gotta have gold all over me. All gold, everything, like Trinidad James. So, yeah, happened. What happened, happened. I fixed it. I got my gold back. Who's next?
Now, Graham, I have to ask you, now that you are the second MCW Global Champion, do you think you're going to be more confident in your future matches now that you've held both titles?
As y'all knew this from day one, all right? No one beats me. If you look at the tape, because I know all the tapes from all these matches have been looked at here recently, okay? When have you ever seen me pin? When have you seen me actually lose a championship? I don't lose. Dave, yes, you won the match, but the ref didn't count it, so still, I haven't been pinned. Martin Mayhem had to beat you to get the title, okay? Nobody's gonna pin the champ. All right, the only way that somebody's going to beat me is pinning me 1, 2, 3, and it ain't happened yet, and guess what?
Well, sorry to cut you off there, Graham Hall. Corruption won't protect you forever. Sooner enough, you're going to get yours, and you're going to be pinned. But unfortunately, we're going to have to cut you off because we got to continue with the match here tonight. We just had JoJo Omega enter the ring, and we are now waiting for the one and only Tony Barrasso to make his entrance here.
Don't worry, guys. My protege will be out soon, and I'll be out here to chop it up with you again.
Hold up. I have some quick questions for Graham, actually. Where'd you learn to fly like that? I said you had a little Samoan in you, but
do you know Conan?
I learned it from a Mexican friend of mine.
Oh.
but who was that?
Now, as amazing as Graham Hall's flying and acrobatic abilities are, we do have to concentrate on the fact that we are getting a new Tony Barrasso here in the ring tonight. He is looking totally different. His attitude has totally changed. And we saw that at Mayhem Mania. Tonight, we're probably going to see a lot more of this new Tony Barrasso.
Now, I'm gonna have to ask you, Dave, what makes you think that Tony Barrasso is actually better than he was before?
There's something about him, the way he carries himself, the way that he acts, the way that he talks. There, again, is something about Tony Barrasso. I can't put my finger on it, but the fact of the matter is I know good talent, and there's a good shining example hidden somewhere inside this individual. Perhaps it just needs MCW to bring it out of him and show the world what a truly great wrestler he is.
Hopefully we get to see that tonight, as this is the new and improved Tony Barrasso's first singles match here at MCW.
And I have to say already, considering the size of Jojo Omega, Tony Barrasso has already shown himself to be truly amazing. And to deal with such a huge-sized individual and opponent, I think speaks a lot about his character and his willingness to go on.
Now, everyone watching, you have to keep in mind, Jojo Omega and Tony Barrasso are two completely different styled wrestlers. One very energetic, as the other one is very technical and strong.
I'm still amazed at the fact that Tony Barrasso is able to throw around Jojo Omega like he's a sack of potatoes.
Oh, but Jojo's throwing back, lifting Tony right over his head.
Then again, that's not a difficult feat.
Omega splash!
Wow.
Tony pushes him off. Jojo tosses him again right over his head.
You know, I gotta say, ever since Jojo Omega's debut, he's been very impressive lately, as he's just showing dominance completely in every match he's in.
I hired him for a reason.
I'm very amazed at his immediate success here in MCW, and I can only expect great things coming from Jojo Omega.
And end of day, until then, Tony kicks out.
Wow, there's the resiliency you see from Tony Barrasso, the former Boston fan. I don't know if he's a Red Sox fan still. You don't see any logos on him, and look at him now.
Like I said, I think there's something new with Tony Barrasso. I think that something's changed with him, and he's shown it with his attitude here tonight in this match.
Tony Barrasso hit him with that beautiful European uppercut.
Tony Barrasso is not an unskilled individual. Quite the opposite. I think it's just a challenge that he needed to come out of his shell.
You know, I too think he needed this type of change for him. Because, as you can see, he's completely dominating the match. You know, at first I thought Jojo was going to have the lead, but so far, I'm going to go with Tony.
Tony just hit an airplane spin. One, two, kick out by Jojo Omega.
I'm still trying to figure out how Tony can pick up such a mass that is Jojo Omega.
That's unbelievable. I think he's been in CrossFit.
Jojo Omega hitting him with those elbows. Four, five, six. He keeps dropping it. Seven, eight, nine, ten. And our big one's coming. Ooh, that has to stop the heart.
That's the signature repetitive elbows by Jojo Omega. You know this guy never wants to give up. Some of you don't notice, but Jojo Omega has a former MMA background on him. Maybe I think that gives him the advantage in MCW more than most of the roster.
Oh no, Tony's measuring for something. Oh, he used Jojo Omega's own move on him. He hit him with
what?
A mixtape. He hit him with a mixtape.
Beautiful.
Tony Barrasso with
but
the
mixtape. But Jojo kicks out.
Whoa. That's gotta be deep for Jojo. Stuff just got picked up quickly and dragged. Oh my god.
I know. Tony with a neck breaker. Ooh, that had to snap the neck.
What a Tony is smart or crazy. I don't know if he was taunting JoJo or if he was just playing along.
No, you're crazy.
Oh no. JoJo picks Tony up from the bottom and powerbombs him straight to the canvas.
Huge hit. And ricochet off the mat.
He's doing it again. Picking up all that dead weight. And dropping him straight down.
There's the strength, the advantage I've been telling you about during this match.
Another edge is he done.
I'm going to have to say, I think I spotted the difference between the old and new Tony Barrasso as this one, looking less shy and just full throttle once he enters this ring. He's a new man, and he's not scared.
When he hears that bell, he turns into a completely different person. Tony Barrasso pounding the head of JoJo against the canvas. It's about 12 times so far. Oh no, Tony picks him up again with another airplane spin. He's taking him around the ring.
JoJo. Unbelievable strength. What a underdog Tony Barrasso has been.
One, two, three. Tony Barrasso beats Omega in this stand.
That's what Tony could do. That's unbelievable.
I had even counted him out, and yet here he is winning this match against one of probably the strongest competitors at MCW.
That's the thing that most people don't know. Whether you like him or not, Tony Barrasso is just going to do one thing, and that's going to be fight.
Well, hats off to you, Tony, because you put up a great fight here tonight, and you truly showed yourself to be part of the integral roster of MCW.
Man, I gotta stand up and give it to him.
Give him what?
A chocolate bar. And a t-shirt that you can find at markd.spreadshirt.com.
And that's a great looking t-shirt. It says, Fight Tony, Fight. But yet again, be sure to check it out, markd.spreadshirt.com.
You can also find the Devious merch. Where is that at?
You can find that at deviousdaverose.spreadshirt.ca. That's right. I'm based out of here in Canada with all the snow. But don't you worry. All your products will come nice and clean, sealed in a nice cardboard box.
And if you want grand merchandise, I said, where do they go?
You can find that at recklesstv.spreadshirt.com for the latest grand hall merchandise that you see here at MCW.
Enough of our sponsors, let's get on to the next match. I think we have a great match coming up. We're making a debut!
The debut! Who's that debut?
You shall find out. I think I see Graham coming down the ramp to our commentary table.
Wait, why is Graham... Graham, why are you coming down? Oh, wait a minute.
Did you miss me?
Think I know what the hell's going on. Graham, is this what I think it is?
Hey, I told you. My protege. I want to see what my protege can do up close tonight. He learned
no
from the
No wonder he's been high-flying during the damn matches.
Your protege? This is the first I've heard of it. Who's your protege?
Oh, you're going to see. Just watch and be amazed.
He's going against someone that's maybe four times his size. We're going to see the so-called Deuce.
We are going to see the so-called Deuce in his debut match in MCW against the Annihilator, Tommy NC.
So I'm going to have to assume your protege is Deuce because I don't think you've ever had any affiliation with Tommy NC.
Deuce is awesome.
Oh no, look at Deuce pumping up the crowd.
You're gonna see what he can do. He's small, but he's gonna show you that small guys got big packages.
And now, I understand that you won a title tonight, but don't let it get to your head, even with your new protege, considering I am the number one contender for the hardcore championship title, making me above you in the rankings. So don't get this
going to your head.
Graham, shouldn't Isaac and Dave be honored to have two champions at the same table?
They should be honored, but yet these guys seem ungrateful.
I like your goal. Why is it good on you?
Dave, you sound like you're kind of salty that you're not the champion. What's going on here?
Hey, Graham, can I touch your title?
Can you do what?
Can I touch your title?
Well, no.
The fact
Back
of
away.
The fact of the matter is that although I can't comment too much about it, my lawyers are currently finalizing a deal where my contract has actually been revised to my liking due to the clear negligence and corruption within the referees that exist within MCW. So although I can't comment too much as to what's happening with that, I can say that I'm not wrestling here tonight for the sole fact that my lawyers are just finalizing my contract, and I am assured that there will be no problems going forward with any referees, lest I was to sue the company for rightful losses.
Well,
this is all in my contract.
I hope that you're aware. I hope that you're aware, no matter what your contract says, it does not guarantee you gold.
No. I've never said that one moment. My contract guarantees me legal rights, but I've always done and always said that I need to work hard to get my gold. Unlike you, trying to claim that you deserve something, I work hard for it, and I prove myself to be the most sinister force in MCW.
Guys, I'm sorry I gotta cut you guys off, but we have two great competitors in the ring. Let's focus on them.
Now you gotta see us. The fact that Deuce's debut is here, I gotta ask Graham, what the hell can we expect from Deuce?
You should expect Graham 2.0. This guy is like a son to me. Anything I can do, I've taught him how to do. And all the stuff he knows how to do, he taught me how to do.
Wow, as you can see, the herd piranha looks very similar to yours.
The size difference is incredible, but the fact of the matter is, clearly, out of the gate, Deuce has shown himself to be quite agile, as well as quite capable in dealing with such an opponent like Tommy NC.
Now, Tommy NC had a great match. Won't you guys agree at Sunday's MayhemMania?
That was an incredible match. But I'm not sure if what he faced on Sunday will prepare him for this match here tonight with this new competitor in this inaugural match.
Well, guys, hey, can I tell y'all something about Deuce real quick? I've been telling him ever since he started wrestling, learning from me, that he needed to wear shoes. But the thing is, the boy's got slave feet. For some reason, he doesn't want to wear shoes. He says it makes him more agile not wearing shoes. What do you think about wrestlers that don't wear shoes, fellas?
I have to say they're the best wrestlers because most Samoan wrestlers wrestle shoes.
Yes, because The Rock has had shoes.
You make me laugh because the fact of the matter is technical individuals like myself love it when you idiots don't wear shoes because it's all the better for me to stomp on them and break one of those little piggy toes that you have.
And I'm going to have to agree.
You just hit him with the bullet. The bullet punch.
That bullet punch has taken out many a dudes in the street.
I don't think Tommy NC even expected that from such an individual.
Now where is Deuce from again?
Atlanta, Deuce Georgia.
Deuce is from Atlanta, Georgia.
What the hell's in Atlanta, Georgia?
Coca-Cola.
Seems to me like Tommy NC looks like a deer in headlights. I don't think he ever expected this sort of resistance from this individual.
The ref! Whoa! I thought all the corrupted refs were gone. The ref just pushed Deuce by accident. I don't know if it was an accident or not.
You've gotta be kidding me.
Mark, I thought you fixed the ref problem.
I tried. I screened all my refs. Maybe that was just maybe it was a sign of self-defense because Deuce was running towards the ref.
Ladies and gentlemen, I would have to say that I think I did see Tommy NC slip a dollar bill in that ref's pants.
I think we're going to have to keep our eye on this particular ref.
What the hell is his name, Mark?
Chuck Chuckerson,
you son of a bitch. I'm going to find you, and I'm going to have a talk with you.
Juanita, bring me a damn water.
Can you tell Guadalupe to bring a pina colada?
That Tommy NC looks like he's still in the business.
Deuce just did a rolling headbutt. I think that hurt him, bro.
No, don't ever count Deuce out. He'll do moves that look like they hurt him, but that boy feels no pain.
I've
had matches against him in the damn training arena. This boy right here, as long as he doesn't want my championship, we don't have a problem.
Yeah, but did you just see that 450 headbutt that he's just connected with Tommy and C? That is not safe.
He calls this move the 404. It kills people.
The 404.
The 404 connects. I don't think
unbelievable hit.
You could kill somebody with that type of move.
Too soon.
I don't think Tommy NC even saw it coming.
I think someone has to shake him up to wake up.
Too soon.
See, Deuce, for a man of his size, he dominates. I know you see that.
Especially his drop kicks to the vertebrae. It's quite lethal.
Isaac, I think you should stop talking about stuff like that.
You know, Graham, if I ever want a good workout and a good punching bag, I'll be sure to ask Deuce to do a little sparring with me.
I don't think a punching bag is the word you would use, because after that match, Deuce has proven himself and shown you why he is in this company. He just won.
Well, considering went against Tommy C, I don't think that's a big feat.
Unbelievable match. Deuce annihilating Annihilator.
I will say one thing, that is a great debut for Deuce.
What do you think about this? Why do you think about this?
I gotta go drop a dude and congratulate my player. I'll see you guys at the next event.
Okay.
I'm the champ.
There's
more than one. You didn't know. By the way, Mark Mayhem, what do you think about that match?
I think I'm happy that I hired Deuce. After that match, I need more high flyers.
I think I just found my new punching bag.
I think I just found my new knee buddy.
Hey, RoboCop, go get your knees tuned up.
Oh, I'll tune it up when I see you in the ring and super kick you straight to hell.
Sir, I taught you to super kick. So if anyone's super kicking anyone, it's me super kicking Dave right in the chin.
Enough about who super kicks who. It's an overused freaking move anyways. We got a hell of a match coming up. It's Eddie End, Strong Style versus Jesse J.
You guys
now, this
announced?
Is a match I've been looking forward to for quite some time. Both of these individuals are quite capable, high-flying cruiserweights here at MCW, and they're going to put on a great show next.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the most agile and the most technical and the most high-flying match you will see at MCW.
I don't know about most technical.
Oh, you know what's technical? Coming to America, all the way from Japan, through a boat and two cows.
Eddie N has shown himself to be quite the competitor here at Mayhem Championship Wrestling, and I have no doubt that he will continue to prove himself.
Love the new look, too. What the hell you guys think is on his face?
Those are traditional Japanese paintings, and they indicate that he is ready to face death head on.
Wow.
He has a new haircut too.
Strong words from Strong Style himself. Eddie N is one of those competitors that you can never know what he's going to do. He has knowledge both in Japanese-style wrestling, lucha libre, and North American-style heavyweight wrestling.
Eddie N has been around
anything.
Jesse J, on the other hand, what the hell? Where has he been before, huh? Does he have the experience that Eddie N has?
Jesse has a whole different book of experience. Jesse's fought in the streets. He has fought odds like 15 to 1, and he's always come out on top. You can never underestimate Jesse J because he is truly one of the greatest champions here at MCW, and he will show those here that doubt him how good he truly is.
All right, prediction time. Mark, you go first. Who's going to win this match?
I'm going with my favorite Californian. Yes,
what about you, Dave?
Well, as much as I love Jesse J, I actually believe that the Japanese skill and ability will prove the Terminator here in tonight's match.
And the match is off.
You know, I've been to California before, and I gotta say, the rough streets of El Boyo Heights is quite the place to fight. And I think showing the toughness through there, even though I haven't experienced Japanese fighting, I'm gonna have to go with the Californian himself, Jesse J.
Californian taking control early in this match off. Throws him straight into the turnbuckle. And a beautiful German suplex.
Wow.
Now there is a little bit of a size differential between these two competitors here tonight.
Size means nothing in the MCW ring, as you just saw.
This only happens at MCW. Trust me, more than 5 people are gonna like this.
Jesse's showing no restraint in this match.
This is not the type of company you just walk through.
Another tie-up. Got a head takedown. And he reverses and gets back to his feet.
We're only a few minutes into this match, but I'm absolutely loving it.
Ooh, those knees are deadly from Eddie. Hits him twice with those knees. Isaac, you should learn something from Eddie.
Oh, trust me, I have. You see, me and him in the ladder match, we've been doing everything and everything we could do because he swung me into the ladder, and hell, I've even gave him an awesome sauce to the ladder. But at the end of the day, we were both just very tired, and we couldn't finish the match properly. But hopefully I see this guy in the ring one-on-one in the future of MCW.
Ooh, a dropkick straight to the face of Jesse J.
Strong style has really turned it around in this match.
Jesse J takes control again, throwing it into the turnbuckle with another German suplex.
Dave, I have to ask you, do you think Jesse J's high?
I think he's just ready to win.
I think he blows the wind, if you know what I'm saying.
That would be very healthy if he blew the wind.
In a non-sexual way, we got a great match here. Back and forth, Jesse J, Eddie N, you know what? I don't know who the hell's gonna win this match.
Eddie's dropping those knees everywhere he could.
Eddie N, strong style,
oh,
known for his
knees. Oh, dragon suplex!
As evenly as this match is, my money is still on Eddie N.
Eddie N hits him with that dragon suplex. Ooh, those kicks are deadly. What is he doing? A tilt the world guts bust. Damn, hitting Jesse. Oh no, Eddie N is measuring. He's measuring. What is he going to do?
Oh God.
Oh no, he locks in the Koji clutch.
Holy shit.
Is Jesse J gonna tap?
What great skill.
Very strong move. This has been used to break arms and shoulder blades and necks all at once.
Oh no, Jesse's struggling. He can't move. He has it locked in, but is he gonna tap?
Come on, Jesse.
I'm not sure he can make it.
Oh, he breaks out of it.
Oh, wow. Unbelievable.
Jesse J, how the hell did he do that?
Oh, Jesse catches a kick. Oh, but misses his drop kick.
This is crazy.
No, you're crazy.
Both of these competitors are looking quite tired.
Oh, a drop kick perfectly landed by Eddie, but Jesse kicks right back up. Oh, another dragon suplex. I think he calls that the chasing the dragon.
You know how they say the bigger they are, the harder they fall. Well, as you can see, Jesse J ain't a big guy, and he's gonna ricochet back up.
No, he has not. He's pinned, and he's done.
Oh. But you can't doubt him. He's been a great match.
Him. But those dragon suplexes.
Great, unbelievable. Just as I expected, the one and only Strong Style won the match against Jesse J. But it was a great, great match between these two amazing competitors.
Now, you did see the resiliency at one point, you gotta admit. But, you know, I think that coach
good sportsmanship from the two, shaking each other's hand. This is the Mayhem Code of Honor. This is what every wrestler should be following.
And truly inspiring to see that.
Where's Graham when you need him, huh?
And we're on to our next match.
This is our main event tonight here on Mayhem Championship Wrestling Tuesday Takedown.
Tommy C versus the one, the only owner of the JCS show, Joe Cronin.
Now you've seen these guys in one remarkable tables match Sunday night, but will we see the same factor as Tommy C takes on Joe Cronin? Who will come out victorious? Find out here at MCW.
I find Tommy C coming for redemption in this match after being slammed through a table by Joe Cronin.
I'm going to have to agree due to the fact that he has the words New York in his shirt.
I think Tommy C is out for revenge tonight against Joe Cronin.
Wow. So is that all three predictable match winners? Huh? You think that Tommy C's going to win, Dave?
I just feel that although I placed my money rightfully on Joe Cronin on Sunday, that Tommy C is just so infuriated with his loss that he's going to give it his all tonight.
That's an advantage, in my opinion, of view, from having one match from one day and then a rematch to another, as you know what the hell's going to happen in that ring with that competitor.
Tommy C has to get Sunday night, he
was
being busted open by one of
Dave's
Joe
Cronin's
knees.
Unbelievable.
He was bleeding all over the place.
A lot of splinters involved. Hopefully not up the rear end.
I'll tell you about splinters in the rear end. They're painful.
How would you know?
JoJo Omega slammed me through one, you jackass.
Oh, yeah. My pants aren't on fire.
Joe Cronin.
Host of the JCS. You gotta see this guy. I mean, he knows what the hell, what happens in and behind the interface of professional wrestling.
And that's a fact.
As always, Joe Cronin is looking impeccable.
A lot of people don't know this about Joe Cronin. He's actually done independent wrestling with such wrestlers such as Kofi Kingston. And his super kick is very, very perfect. He's done backyard wrestling. He's been grossing his way to make it up to the pros here at MCW.
Could this be one of those hidden gems available only at MCW?
I think Tommy C is gonna pull through. Use his hockey advantage, you know what I'm saying?
Well, I feel that Tommy NC's only positive here tonight is the fact that he's out for revenge. Other than that, Joe Cronin is the better wrestler.
By the way, you just won 3 years of revenge. You think we're gonna expect anything to happen in the near future between you and the champ?
Well, although I can't speak too much because, again, my lawyers are adjusting the final details on my contract, I will be facing Mark Mayhem for the Hardcore Championship title at April Anarchy.
April Anarchy.
And the best man will come out on top, as always.
That's the main event I can't wait for. But here we have a main event that we are not going to wait for because it's happening right now, damn it. It's Tommy C versus Joe Cronin. Starting off with a bunch of arm holds.
Each individual looking very focused and very ready to try to take the other out.
Now, Mark Mayhem, is it true that there's no stipulation in this?
I'm not sure, but with these two competitors in the ring, it doesn't matter what the stipulation is. They're going to tear each other limb from limb.
You're never going to know what the hell this crazy guy Tommy C is. Maybe that's what the C stands for. Crazy.
No, he's crazy.
Looks to me like Joe Cronin is definitely out for blood.
Ooh, a headbutt. Straight to Joe Cronin from Tommy C. That's that hockey instinct. He doesn't feel pain like a regular man. He uses his body as a weapon with body check.
Punch face to face. Hopefully he won't need the surgery after this match.
Well, you may not know, but Tommy C actually used to belong to the NHL, but he was suspended and then eventually totally removed from the organization for excessive violence.
You got that right. That's C right there in his last name stands for crazy.
2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Huge hits.
9, 10. Straight forearms to the chest of Joe Cronin.
Unbelievable.
Wow.
Looking on the leg, slams it straight on the concrete.
You think Joe actually enjoys this pain, knowing the psychopath he is?
Well, you can never know, but the fact is that it looks like Tommy C is definitely interested in inflicting as much pain as possible on Joe Cronin.
Joe Cronin just hit him with an infamouser.
Wow.
Great agility. Guys, back into the ring.
Joe Cronin does have the hops, as the young kids say nowadays. Ball's life.
Woo! Hitting him with that knife-edge chop.
Hopefully after this match, I'll go up to that girl wearing the fedora at the front seat, and I'm going to say, hey, what's up, sexy? Can I have your number?
Just amazing in-ring action here at Mayhem Championship Wrestling Tuesday Takedown.
Oh,
wow. You see the agility and the height that he's had. He just bounced off the mat like a pinball.
The crowd is going absolutely wild for this.
Experience. The knee is one of the most sensitive.
A power bomb to Joe Cronin.
One of the most sensitive body parts in the wrestling industry. You don't know what the hell's gonna happen from jumping to running. You gotta know, you can't do anything in wrestling without your knees.
And this is in fact a battle between YouTube's two greatest broadcasters.
Uh-oh. A pedigree!
Oh my god, Kerman's got it.
1, 2, 3. Tommy C beats Joe Cronin with that pedigree standing right in the ring. Getting him to go to the hard Joe Cronin.
That is what an amazing result.
for this main event here at Mayhem Championship Wrestling Tuesday Takedown. Unbelievable.
But you gotta know, that just makes them equal. It's a one for one, Joe and Tommy.
I'm just still amazed at what we saw here tonight.
Yeah, I'm amazed by the fact that you lost on Sunday.
Mitch. Well, I'm amazed that you're still standing with those little gimpy knees of yours. You know, I'm gonna help you up, help you to your car.
That's why I got your sister for.
Let's not talk about each other's sister. Isaac, your knees are broken. Dave, you put up a great fight, and that's why you're getting your knees back. But Isaac,
damn right.
That's why you never get title shots, because your damn knees are always broken.
But you know what? I quit. Just kidding. I need to stop. That's good.
Okay, and that's all for Mayhem Championship Wrestling Tuesday Takedown. I'm Mark Mayhem, and you all been Mark. That's Devious Dave on the mic.
Stay devious.
Isaac, say something stupid.
My knee.
And we are off.